In the wake of Franklin's lost expedition, many rescue operations searched in vain for the lost explorer. Though they did not find Franklin or his crew, they did greatly increase the knowledge of the Canadian Arctic archipelago. Countless rescue efforts sailed, charted, corrected, and refined maps of the region. By 1854, Robert McClure was successfully able to map out a possible route through the Arctic archipelago that would allow sailors to travel from the Atlantic to the Pacific through the Northwest Passage. McClure, however, was not able to traverse the passage as his ship sank before he could complete the voyage. The honor of being the first to traverse the Northwest Passage would fall to Norwegian explorer Roald Amundsen, and it's his voyage that we examine today. The year was 1900, and Amundsen had just returned to Norway after having successfully served as the first mate on the Belgian Antarctic expedition. Considering himself experienced enough to strike out on his own, Amundsen decided he should be the one to successfully navigate the Northwest Passage for the first time. Though he initially wanted to self-finance the expedition, Amundsen's personal wealth proved nowhere near enough to cover the costs of the journey. He sought funding from a variety of sources and had to widely advertise his plans, and this was something that never sat well with the very humble Amundsen, who always preferred to talk of his endeavours only after he had actually achieved them. With his funding secure, Amundsen purchased the 47-ton sloop Goja and spent the summer of 1901 sailing it around the coast of Greenland, getting acclimated with the icy waters. Over the next 2 years, he spent time testing equipment and carefully selecting the 6 crew members for the voyage. All was ready in June 1903 when Amundsen and crew set sail. Amundsen, fully immersed in the history of the Northwest Passage, followed a similar path to Franklin, sailing first to Greenland, then across Baffin Bay to Beechey Island, where the expedition turned south and headed down Peel Sound and the Franklin Strait to King William Island. The journey was not plain sailing, with storms, fires in the engine room, and the Goja striking a rock, nearly bringing the expedition to a tragic and early end. The crew and ship managed to persevere, however, and safely put down anchor in King William Island at what is now known as Goja Haven, the island's only inhabited settlement. Though the crew could have proceeded on the rest of the journey straight away, they actually spent 2 whole years anchored on King William Island. Why, you may ask? For science, of course. Prior to leaving, the crew had undertaken the task of relocating the magnetic North Pole. This required constant magnetic measurement for over a year in a location within 200 kilometers of the pole. Crew members Vik and Ristvedt constructed a small shack on King William Island and successfully relocated the magnetic North Pole, which was in a slightly different location than had previously been recorded 73 years previous. During this stay on King William Island, Amundsen and the rest of the crew explored the Boothia Peninsula on foot, coming into contact with local Inuit tribes while doing so. Amundsen spent a lot of time interacting with the locals and learning their way of life. He kept a large journal recording their diet, their clothes, and their methods of survival in the Arctic environment, which would prove very helpful for him in later life. After the scientific goals of the expedition were met, the ship was free from ice, and on the 13th of August 1905, Amundsen and crew set sail into the unknown. Ice and fog provided constant perils, and the ship was in near continuous danger of running aground. However, after several days of difficult but speedy sailing, they set down anchor at Cape Colburn in Victoria Island, the furthest point any ship coming from the Bering Strait in the west had ever ventured. Amundsen had completed the Northwest Passage. Though he had hoped to reach civilization before the winter, Amundsen and his crew became stuck in the ice at King Point on Herschel Island and had to spend the winter there with 12 other stranded vessels. During this time, Amundsen managed to trek overland to Eagle City, Alaska, to send telegrams of his achievement to the wider world. Unfortunately, it was also during this winter period that one of the crew, Vic, became ill and died, thus becoming the only casualty of Amundsen's Northwest Passage expedition. Once the ice cleared, Amundsen and crew were free to sail again and made their way to Nome, Alaska, where they were given a hero's welcome by the many gold prospectors present in the town at the time. The crew parted ways with their ship at Nome, heading home to Norway as national heroes, having successfully navigated the Northwest Passage, the famous sea route that had captured the minds and imaginations of so many. A great achievement for the new nation of Norway, and the first of many great achievements for Amundsen himself.